Brad, and thank you everybody for being here. I apologize for being a little tardy. Both Melanie and I are blessed with parents that are still with us, but they're also very ailing. And so I left session early yesterday, and I was actually printing out some of the things that was distributed to Congress. Well, the last several weeks have been extremely busy. Fortunately, as a committee chairman, one of my priorities is to make sure all my bills got those from committee, which I finally did accomplish on Tuesday. And then the last few days, we've been working on some personal bills. If you've been watching the papers and the news, we did get debt limit increase passed in Deadwood, as well as some licensing bills. So we are pleased with that. We think that would be a good thing for Deadwood. Other than that, most of the discussion, as we've been moving the House bills, obviously, is the education bill. And I won't take up too much time right now because I just printed off the summary of what the amendments to the House Bill 1234 that went through the Senate Education yesterday on. It's an entirely different animal, not only from what was proposed by the governor at the beginning of the session, but also which passed the House. And I assume we will pass a bill this week, but it'll obviously go to conference committee, and so stay tuned. It will still continue to be more as we go through the process. Other than that, things are starting to wind down to a certain degree that we are being able to concentrate on some of the things. One of the surprising things is we really haven't had a lot of talk about budget, and I won't take much time about that because I know Fred is more in tune with the revenue numbers which came down on Thursday, but there is going to be a little bit more money that's available. We were trying to prioritize those the other day in our caucus as what we would possibly do with them. A lot of people were thinking reserves would be a good place, which I don't have a problem with, but I did make a pretty good pitch to try to get at least a portion of that money, somewhere around $12 million is what might be available. Above and beyond what we've been looking at least a portion of that, hopefully about $1 million to be set aside for the pine beetle epidemic, and have that move to the legal passport of the state, so again designated to be used here in Black Hills in some of the affected areas that haven't had a real good shot yet. Other than that, we'll look forward to your questions, and I appreciate you all being here this morning.